Here it is, the replacement for the Ranger. 2023 Ford Bronco, obviously, two-door, obviously. Big bend package, 2.3 liter motor, and 10-speed automatic. Non-Sasquatch, unfortunately. There wasn't any close enough to the house where I was willing to travel to buy it, and even if there was, with the markups and everything, it was just too much money. It was only my fourth day of ownership that I started tearing this thing apart to make it better, of course. I started with a Flowmaster Outlaw Series muffler delete. I had an AFE muffler delete on the Ranger and thought it sounded decently enough, especially for a four-cylinder, so, you know, figured why not go the same route with this. I'll make a short video on the muffler delete a little later on, but the second thing up was having a 2-inch Rough Country lift installed and having these 35-inch Kenda Clever RTs put on the wheels I had on the Ranger. So Sasquatch package or not, I'm still gonna have some fun. I ended up buying the Rough Country third brake light extension. I haven't installed it yet, but as you can see, the thing is almost unnecessary. If you live in a state that has super picky inspection laws, I'm not sure if they'd let this fly or not, because, I mean, if you're in a smart car or something, you're probably not going to see that third light, but we'll get around to putting that in eventually. My previous vehicle, and there's a couple videos of it up there, was a 2021 Ford Ranger STX. I loved the hell out of that truck. It was quick enough, it was capable enough, it would tow anything I would be towing home. COVID is still jacking with everything. So the truck, around 38,000 miles, the center bearing in the drive shaft took a shit. It was just growling everywhere. Of course, this happened about a week after my inspection sticker ran up, which for a new sticker, I was going to need to have a center bearing that didn't make a hell of a lot of noise. The truck was still under warranty, which was cool, but when I took it into the dealership and they confirmed my suspicions, they told me that new drive shafts were back ordered with no ETA when they would be off of back order. The last time the dealership dealt with that issue on another Ranger, it took them 6 months to get a drive shaft. So I stretched a bit and took it as justification to upgrade. So to wrap this up quickly, I suppose, I've got a little over 2,600 miles on this thing so far, and I regret nothing. It's just as comfy as the Ranger. It's more efficient than the Ranger, it's quicker than the Ranger, it'll fit a bigger tire than the Ranger, it'll go more places than the Ranger, it's easier to park than the Ranger. You know, not that that thing is hard to park, but if you're a sissy, you know, that's something you're going to be concerned about, so here you go. Yeah, it's great. Taking it wheeling for the first time, hopefully this weekend. Try to get as much footage as I can. But, I mean, stay tuned, I guess. Take it down the 8th mile. Why not? If you're thinking about buying a Bronco and you can find one and you can afford it, I'd say go for it. Because this thing is bitchin'.